Okay, now we need to cut the smaller end of your hammer to the right length. Now, if we look on our print, we can see that there are three dimensions that are pretty much going to be set in stone at this time. Okay, so once we've cut this 8 1/4 inch length, that's going to fix in space where this 4 3/8 dimension is. And also, this will be our, before we cut this off, this is our last chance to fix this 1/4 inch shoulder. If it doesn't have the right dimensions. So make sure that the 1/4 inch shoulder, the 4.375, that these different dimensions are correct before you proceed to cut off the 8 1/4 length, because that's going to set everything else in stone more or less. All right, so what we want to do is mark the 8 1/4, and we want to mark it from the reference shoulder, and this is longer than our dial calipers will open. So what we're going to do is use this fixture. So we're going to place it in the fixture and bump up the shoulder against this edge, and then we'll use the little scribe here to mark the 8 1/4 inch mark. Now, to cut this to length, we could use a what's called a parting tool, and that would look like this. But these are just a little bit problematic, so we don't use them in this class. What we're going to do is use a hacksaw, and then we're going to face it to length. So we're going to clamp this in the vise. And we're going to cut long, so we want to cut this longer than our mark. We want to leave extra material behind because we don't want a hacksaw end on our hammer. What we want to do is face this to length. So we're just using this as a roughing cut. So we want to cut and save our mark. So we're going to cut a little bit long. All right, so put it in the vise and then just cut it with the hacksaw. And then we're going to put it back in the lathe, but we're going to put it back in a different way. This is going to be a different way than we've done before. We're going to put it all the way up into the chuck. So we don't want to hold by the knurls. We want to make sure that we're not accidentally clamping on the shoulder there. What we want to do is make sure that the entire 4 3/8 diameter extends into the chuck. And we want to leave just maybe an inch or so extending out of the chuck. All right, next we're going to move the tool to a safe place and make sure that our power feed is set to move the in the cross slide direction, so that it's the facing direction. So we'll verify that, and then we'll bring the tool down close to the part, turn on the spindle, then move the tool close to the part, and we'll just face off an end. Okay, so this is just going to clean it up well enough so that we can get a good measurement and see how far we are away from our mark. Then we're going to place the dial indicator back on the lathe, and we're going to zero it out. And we're going to use the dial indicator to tell us when we have moved that distance over. So here we're 120 thousandths of an inch long, and so we're going to zero out on the end here, and we're going to keep making facing cuts until the dial indicator has moved 120 thou. When we get to our last pass, we want to use the power feed, and again, make sure that it's all set up properly before you do this, because you're working very close to the chuck, and it would be bad to feed in the carriage direction. So we're going to use the power feed to face it off and make a really nice looking machine marks on the end. Now, when that's to size, we want to move the dial indicator off of the lathe for just a minute. We're going to put it back on, but we want to make sure that it's not there while we're moving things around, so we're going to take the dial indicator off. And we're going to actually rotate the tool post. So there's a big nut on top of the tool post. Take that and loosen it. All of these, remember, these fasteners follow the right-hand rule, so turn it in the right-hand direction the left-hand direction to loosen it. And then we're going to rotate the tool so that it aligns with this 45 degree indicator. Then we're going to move tighten the tool down and in this position, and then we'll move it down until it just contacts the end of our workpiece. This is going to be our zero point. What we're trying to do now is measure and cut a 50 thou chamfer. So at this point, when the tool is bumped up next to the workpiece, we're going to put the dial indicator on. Back on the lathe, same as before. We're going to zero it out, and then I'm going to move off of the part. So I'm going to move over here to the right a little bit, and then power on the spindle, and then move back into the zero point, and then take 50 thou more off. So now we've made our 50 thou chamfer cut. All right, then we want to take the part out, and we want to reset our tool post. So with the part out of here, we want to align the tool post. There are two things that we want to be very careful of whenever we're changing the settings of the tool post. One of them is we don't want to have any part of this compound that is sticking out in front of the tool. So we want to make sure that the tool is the farthest thing forward. And we also want to make sure that the T-nut is not hanging out. We want to make sure that the T-nut is nice and in position in the T-slot. All right, when that's the case, we'll take this, and what I like to do is to bump this tool holder up against the chuck, and that'll get it pretty close to straight. So it's at a 90-degree angle to the axis of our cutter, and then we'll kind of halfway tighten the nut on the top and then move it off of the chuck and then go ahead and get it good and tight. All right, we're now ready to thread the end of the hammer, so we'll take it over to the drill press, and we're not going to use the drill press in the traditional way that you would use a drill press. We're just going to use it as a fixture to help us get our threads started nice and straight and square on the end of our handle. So we're going to put our hammer into the vise. We're going to first of all put this little rod of tool steel down, and we're going to rest the hammer on that tool steel, and then we're going to put this V-block on top. And what that's going to do, that's going to lift us up off of the bottom of the vise. This vise has seen better days, so that's going to lift us up off of the bottom of the vise and get everything nice and straight and square. So get this good and tight. Then you're going to put the die stock on the end of the hammer, and you want this so that it's in this orientation, so that the top of the die stock is the side that has the rim around it. Okay, so the rim side up, and you're going to place the die stock down onto the end of your workpiece. That chamfer should allow it to fit on there nice and straight. And then with the help of a classmate, they're going to pull down on the quill of the drill press and just apply enough pressure to get the die stock nice and straight and get it started straight on the end of the hammer handle. Once you've been around about two turns with the die stock, then you can let go with the drill press and just continue tapping or cutting the threads down until the end of the hammer is even with the top of the die stock. So I'll place this aluminum block on here so that you can see that. That's the distance that we want to thread. Now, to get the die stock off, you'll reverse the direction that you're rotating and just gently back it up. And you want to be real careful when you get to the very end so that when you finish up, you don't gouge the threads up at the top. So you want to support the die as it exits the end of the hammer. So I put my hand under it as you get towards the end of the cut. All right, now we want to saw off the carrier off the back end of our hammer. So we're going to place it in the cold cutoff saw, and we want to place it so that we cut it a little bit long again, and we want it to just leave about, I don't know, about 20 or 30 thou longer than the edge here. So that shoulder is the exact length that we want our hammer to be. So when we get done cleaning up the end, we're going to face it the same way we faced off the other end of the hammer. We're going to face it off to the point, because this is where all our measurements were made. They were made all off of that edge. And if we can just wind up facing it off to that length, then everything will be brought nicely into tolerance. So we're going to place it in the cold cutoff saw, allow about 20 or 30 thou, and then we will saw the end off. Now, because we have knurls on this hammer, it's kind of a dicey affair to clamp back on that knurled section. So we're going to use this hose. This is a little bit of a hack, but it works pretty well. So you're going to put this piece of hose on the knurls to protect them, and then you want to put the hose into the chuck, but you want to make sure that the chuck jaws are not on the seam. So you want to make sure that the seam is in between the chuck jaws, and then you want to get it good and firm. Now we're going to use the same procedure we did on the other end of the hammer. We're going to face it to length, and we're going to measure how far we are away from that edge. And in fact, the tolerances are open enough that if you did everything right along the way, you can do this one by sight. If you just face down until that shoulder is just paper thin, you will be well within the tolerances. But it's always a good idea to measure, and so you can do this where you measure the thickness of that flange that's left behind and just face that distance off. So that works fine. Then you're going to take the hammer out of this lathe, and you're going to go to the lathe that is set up. There's one particular lathe that is set up with a radiusing tool on it, and you will do the same setup with the knurls and the hose. On that lathe, make sure that the seam is showing, that it's, that you're not clamped on the seam, that the seam is not under a chuck jaw. And then you're going to use this radius tool to go in and just cut out a nicely formed radius. The tolerance is pretty nice on this. It's just 1/8 inch in this direction and 1/8 inch in that direction has to be cut. And you want to make sure that you avoid those sharp points on either end of the arc. All right, and with that, you're done with your hammer. Put your name on the nicely machined part and turn that in.